We will need technology.
Some self-exiled former cabinet ministers have called for the immediate resignation from the government of Defense Minister Opam Chinguri after her weekend spat in which she accused China for creating the deadly COVID-19 virus and failing to contain it. Following the death of her colleague Ellen Gwaradzimba last Friday from the COVID-19, Muchinguri told a journalist that the Chinese were responsible for that pandemic that has seen millions of deaths and infections across the globe. At the time of her death, Gwaradzimba, who has since been declared a national heroine, was the Manicaland provincial minister. She is expected to be buried this week at the National Heroes Acre in Harare. The disease is now on a fresh peak now. Cases are rising again, and they, the Chinese, are the ones who started their experiments and things got out of hand. And now their experiments are costing us, Muchinguri is heard saying in an audio interview by one unknown journalist. The first human cases of COVID-19 were reported by officials in Wuhan City, China, at the end of 2019. They cannot control this now, and they have costed us. Those whom we call our all-weather friends, look at what they have done to us, she added. However, some former ZANU-PF senior officials who were part of the G40 faction before they were expelled from the ruling party in 2017 have demanded that Muchinguri should immediately resign as the defense minister. The former higher education minister Godfrey Gandawa, who is now in self-exile in South Africa, said Muchinguri was either ignorant or incompetent before demanding that she should resign over mindless behavior. How could a defense minister be so easily deceived? If Opa could be manipulated with such ease, one wonders how she ended up in a position where she is in charge of national security, unlikely to be married, he said. Opa should not be taken seriously and really has no business being in the government. It cannot be the case that a government minister says coronavirus is a case from God and then changes to claim that it was accidentally made in a Chinese lab. In formal and normal countries where leaders are held up to a standard, Opa would have tendered her resignation in shame. Another G40 member and former tourism minister Walter Mzembe, who is also in self-exile in South Africa, described his erstwhile colleagues in ZANU-PF as fake mourners. The chief mourners of any funeral is the ZANU-PF. They have been mourning and burying us for 41 years, serious dramatis est funerals, but they do not mean a thing of what they say at those funerals, said Mzembe. However, the former ZANU-PF Mashonaland and West Provincial Chairperson Themba Mliswa, who is now an independent MP, came to Muchinguri's defense, saying the minister should not be roasted for her comments as she was in mourning. Mliswa also took offense after the foreign ministry issued a statement dismissing Muchinguri's comments as not the government's position. Going public with a statement premised against someone grieving was both unnecessary and irrational. It further exposes the infighting in the party, the ZANU-PF, he also added on to say. Muchinguri doubles as the ZANU-PF national chairperson. Here is someone who is in pain and mourning, and in that moment emotionally, the person is in a mess. These are scenarios where former President Robert Mugabe would use quiet diplomacy. Honorable Muchinguri is a dedicated cadre for whom it's unfortunate to be exposed to such unfair moves. The foreign affairs statement on Honorable Muchinguri is a low blow that does not pay cognizance to the context in which she expressed herself.